Hello and welcome to another MessageBird developer tutorial. Today we'll show you how to build appointment reminders with MessageBird's SMS API using Node.js. You can either walk through the tutorial with us here or get started now by downloading the sample application in the MessageBird developers portal using the link on your screen. First, let's open a console pointed at the directory into which we've placed the sample application and run npm install to install the MessageBird SDK for Node.js and other dependencies. The SDK is loaded with the following require statements in index.js. We need to set a MessageBird API key as a parameter. As you see here, it's taken from an environment variable, so we define it in the env file. You can copy the key from the MessageBird dashboard and paste it here. Let's collect our users' phone numbers during the appointment or reservation booking process. To do this, we'll create a sample form, which you can see in the file views home handlebars. This form will ask us for the user's name, their desired treatment, their contact number, and date and time of their appointment. The route that drives this is defined as app.get in index.js. The user's input is sent to the route app.postbook defined in index.js. So let's check our user's input. To do this, we simply need to validate that the user has entered a value for every field in the form. If they haven't, we show the form again with an error message. Next, we'll check the appointment date and time. To give enough time for a helpful reminder, we'll confirm that the date and time are valid and at least 3 hours and 5 minutes in the future. Of course, you can change this parameter to meet the needs of your specific use case. If the user has entered an earlier time, we'll show an error message. We recommend using a library such as Moment, which we've already integrated into our sample application. That makes working with date and time calculations a breeze. Let's now check our user's phone number. We can perform this with MessageBird's lookup API, which takes a phone number entered by a user, validates the format, and returns information about the number, such as whether it's a mobile or fixed line number. In the SDK, you can call the MessageBird lookup function. This function takes three arguments: the phone number, a country code, and a callback function. Providing a default country code enables users to supply their number in a local format without the country code. This country code is also configured in the environment file. In the callback function, we handle four different cases. If a code 21 error occurs, this means MessageBird was unable to parse the phone number. A message is shown to the user. If another error code occurs, this means something else went wrong in the API. Another message is shown to the user. If no error occurs, but the phone number's type is something other than mobile, we'll let the user know that they need to provide a mobile number. Lastly, if everything is okay, this means a mobile number was entered successfully. Let's now schedule the reminder. Using Moment, we can easily specify the time for a reminder. Then it's time to call MessageBird's API. You can provide an originator parameter for the sender ID, specify recipients, just one in our case, and set the scheduled timestamp when the message should be sent. And finally, here's the content of the message. Once that's set, let's wrap it up by storing the appointment. The application's logic continues in the callback function for the MessageBird messages create API call, where we need to handle both error and success part cases. Also, for the purpose of the sample application, we simply persist the appointment to a global variable in memory. This is where, in practical applications, you would write the appointment to a persistence layer such as a file or database. We also show a confirmation page, which is defined in views confirm handlebars. Let's run a quick test by running the node index.js command from your console. Then, point your browser at localhost to see the form and schedule your appointment. If you use a live API key, a message will arrive to your phone 3 hours before the appointment. And that's it. Nice work. We've just built an appointment reminder system using the MessageBird SMS API. For more guides on how to build communication solutions with our SMS, voice, and chat APIs, please visit the MessageBird YouTube channel and developer portal. Thanks for watching.